Objectives. By the end of this unit, you will be able to define digital safety, explain the basics of digital safety, and identify the necessary digital safety elements for tech products in education. Protecting students online extends well beyond privacy. Digital safety focuses on exposure to digital content, communications, and more, ensuring that risks of harm from these media are minimized and that there are policies and procedures in place that both prevent and appropriately respond to such harms. First, make sure that the product has a clear terms of service document. A terms of service document is a set of rules that users agree to follow in order to use an online service. These agreements are legally binding, though the company is free to change them. In order for your students to be able to use a product, the terms of service must not contain terms that violate the law or fall short of acceptable safety practices. Like the privacy policy, the terms of service is primarily a legal document to protect the company. However, it also serves a safety function, setting the rules for what is appropriate and acceptable content and conduct while using the website or application. It may also help you to understand important aspects of using the service, such as the acceptable minimum age for users. The terms of service isn't the only way to review safety practices, but it is always a helpful tool in the process. When reviewing for safety, there are two elements you're going to need to focus on: content and communications. Visual images, video, and audio are all different types of content. Content can either be product-generated or user-generated. Product-generated content is contained within the service and is created by the company itself. Just as you would with a film, book, or song, you should review product-generated content to make sure that it is both appropriate for your students and complies with school policy. User-generated content is, not surprisingly, created by users. This type of content is much harder to review and control. Products without oversight of user content can leave your students exposed to inappropriate material. If students can access user-generated content from others, you'll need to make sure that there is a moderator manually enforcing safe content policies. Communication refers to text, audio, and other means of interaction digitally. Online communication has some great benefits for education, but also poses risks. So the next question you'll need to ask is, with whom are my students communicating? Cyberbullying, harassment, and other inappropriate digital communication can come from many sources, including members of the school community. If students have the ability to digitally interact with other students, teachers, parents, or any other users, it is best to ensure that those communications are also moderated. Abuse reporting is another means of enforcing safe content and communication. On many digital platforms, social reporting is used as a moderation technique. This allows for users to anonymously report other users who have violated the terms of service through bullying, harassment, posting inappropriate content, and more. If users can communicate or generate content, you should check the terms of service to make sure there's an anonymous abuse reporting mechanism. It is best to make sure that any abuse reporting preserves the anonymity of the reporter.